Wordsworth's preface to the second edition of the Lyrical Ballads, 1800. The preface is entitled Poetry and Poetic Diction. As you see from the title, it's the preface to the second edition of the Lyrical Ballads, which means that the first edition has no preface. The first edition is produced in 1798. It was a book written in collaboration between William Wordsworth and Samuel Taylor Coleridge. However, this first edition is anonymous. The second edition, on the other hand, came 2 years later, in 1800, and William Wordsworth, together with Samuel Taylor Coleridge, decided to turn this event to proclaiming the rise of the Romantic movement in Britain. Although the poems inside the book were written by both William Wordsworth and Samuel Taylor Coleridge, yet the preface is written by William Wordsworth only. The preface is considered the British Romantic Manifesto, or the most important document that proclaims the rise of Romanticism in Britain. That's why the name of William Wordsworth is related to the foundation of English Romanticism. In the preface, Wordsworth speaks about the subject matter or the principal object. He is explaining to his readers that they are going to meet themes about rustic humble life, الحياة الريفية المتواضعة. He explains that the subject matter or the principal object of these poems deals with the incidents and situations from common rustic life presented in a simple language with a touch of imagination. So that in his poems inside his book, The Lyrical Ballads, Wordsworth is going to introduce for his readers various examples of rustic life or life of the countryside. The poems will be written in a very simple language, added to it a touch of imagination. What makes these poems more interesting is discussing nature in them, and the poet produces these poems and expresses his ideas in a state of excitement, which means enthusiasm. What are the causes of choosing humble rustic life to be the principal object of these poems? Humble and rustic life is chosen to be the subject matter or the principal object of the poems inside the Lyrical Ballads for four reasons. First, the passion of the heart finds a better soil to express themselves, of course, in humble and rustic life. Second, the passions of the heart are less under restraints. يعني بيكون الواحد الشاعر في حالة استرخاء، مش متعصب، مش متوتر، فبيعرف يعبر عن نفسه بشكل أفضل. Third, because manners of rural life، طريقة الحياة الريفية are more easily comprehended or more easily understood and more durable، باقية أكتر لأنها مفهومة أكتر، باقية في الذاكرة. Fourth, the passion of man unite with the beautiful and the permanent forms of nature، عشان هذه المشاعر مختلطة بالطبيعة. What is the proper language of romantic poetry؟ According to Wordsworth, the proper language of romantic poetry should be the real everyday simple language of rustic people after it's purified. So that Wordsworth again chooses the language of rustic people اللي هي لغة الفلاحين to be the language of poetry, but at first the poet takes this language and purify it and turns it figurative. It's a primitive language, لغة بدائية, because it's related to primitive and simple people. It's a naive language and a passionate language. It's the language of simple men who always communicate with the best parts of nature. اللغة دي لغة بسيطة، هي لغة الناس اللي في حالة تواصل مع الطبيعة اللي هم الفلاحين. Those people are away from social vanity. الفلاحين ما عندهمش نفاق اجتماعي، فبالتالي اللغة بتاعتهم هتكون خالية من النفاق. This language is more permanent، دائمة أكتر في الذاكرة، and philosophical، فيها فلسفة. This language comes up out of repeated experience and regular feelings، لغة تلقائية خارجة من التجارب اليومية المتكررة والمشاعر اليومية. He believes that there is no difference between the language of poetry and the language of prose. He adds a touch of imagination to this language to present it in an unusual way. What about the definition of poetry? For Wordsworth, poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. So that feelings is the central component of English romantic poetry. These feelings are spontaneous, which means they are not under control of the poet himself. Those feelings come out of the heart of the poet. Reason and the thoughts, however, are not completely excluded or dismissed, yet they modify those feelings. Good poetry should strengthen and purify the affections of the readers. His poetry would amuse mankind permanently. Wordsworth also believes that good poetry should amuse mankind permanently and should have moral relations. الشعر الكويس هو اللي هيعجب الناس مدى الحياة ويكون فيه لمحة أخلاقية. The end or the aim of poetry is to produce excitement at the same time with an overbalance of pleasure. الشعر الجيد هو اللي يقدم حالة من الإثارة والمتعة. Who is the romantic poet? The romantic poet, according to Wordsworth, is a man speaking to men, which means that he is an ordinary man. Yet this man has greater degree of sensibility and sensitivity. يعني بيكون حساس شوية وحكيم شوية عن الناس العادية. His reaction towards objects and the situations around him must be more than usual. عشان تكون درجة إحساسه عالية لأي موقف يحصل حواليه ويكتب قصيدة عنه على طول. He should have the ability to think long and deeply. He is the man who will use all his past experience and thoughts to write a poem. لازم يكون حد بيحب التأمل والتفكير بعمق ويقدر يستخدم كل تجارب الماضي في كتابة القصيدة عشان يدينا خلاصة خبرته. The poet must have more enthusiasm and greater knowledge of human nature. لازم يكون عنده معرفة بالناس أكتر مننا ويكون عنده حماس أكتر. He also must have more comprehensive soul. He should be a man pleased by his life and has the power to contemplate. لازم يكون عنده القدرة على التأمل. He must have the power of imagination to be able to create situations which provoke his feelings. What about the style of romantic poems? Wordsworth refuses the neoclassical style for two reasons. First, the neoclassical writers use poetic dictions. Second, they use personification of abstractions. يعني الكتاب بتوع العصر الكلاسيكي الجديد بيستخدموا البويتيك ديكشن مصطلحات شعرية صعبة غير مستخدمة في حياتنا اليومية وتشخيص الكلمات المجردة. Wordsworth aims at making romantic poetry realistic, at using the simple everyday language of ordinary people. The use of personification of abstraction is not part of the ordinary language of ordinary people. Moreover, they are not real. The use of poetic diction is rejected because they are difficult to comprehend by level educated people. They express the soul of the classic, not the English. يعني البويتيك ديكشن كانت شائعة أيام الكتاب الكلاسيكيين بتوع أيام زمان وطريقة الكلام الصعبة دي هي بتعبر عن روحهم وثقافتهم لكن في القرن التسعتاشر ما بقتش خلاص مناسبة إنها تعبر عن العصر اللي الشاعر بيتكلم فيه وبالتالي ما لهاش لازمة إن هو يستخدم اللغة الصعبة دي. This is the end of our lecture. Thanks for watching and goodbye.